With whom I am speaking, the Lambda Center Houston Coffee Bar. Yes, this is Ernestine Tomlin from the telephone company. We've been reviewing your records, and yes, we can do that. We are the telephone company, the higher power of telephone companies. As I said, we've been reviewing your records, and it appears you have mostly incoming calls and not very many outgoing calls. That pegs you as suspicious. You're in AA Clubhouse? Is that a ranking in the National Book of Clubhouses? It also says here that there are complaints that someone has been decorating their instrument. That is what I said, their instrument. It says here you have a 1979 Princess model phone. Is that correct? Should you ever go out of business, we will need to collect that instrument. All those modifications would incur quite a penalty fee. You're never going to go out of business. What are you, the telephone company? Hello? Hello? I must have struck some nerve.
You know, Dan, our little variety act was just bought out by Illusions, the prestigious AA theater company that supports the Lambda Center.
Whoa there. Those were a lot of words. Illusions? AA? Lambda Center? Does anybody know what this dick is jockeying about?
Oh, my God. Dan, I forgot what a pain in the ass you can be.
And speaking of double A ass, I just celebrated 10 years sober.
Wow. Congratulations. You know, I've been in Al-Anon about 10 years as well.
Oh. And as we say, and as we say in AA, keep coming back.
Yeah, we say that in Al-Anon too, but then we add, bring the whole family.
In that communion.
Yeah, kind of like playing sobriety Jenga with a twist.
We get the strangest calls around here. That woman who just called, I swear she was calling from the 1970s. What was she talking about? A princess phone?
Sonny had one of those way back in the day. He decorated it with rhinestones. Joanne. Earth to Joanne.
Oh, finally! A place where I can order a double and not get into trouble!
You can still get a buzz without booze.
I hope I'm not dressed too flashy. You know, you can't go wrong with Versace when you're trying to fit in.
No wonder the other flamingos picked on you.
So what can I get you two boys, girls, non-binaries? What can I say? You both have quite the flair.
We are looking for mocktails.
Flocktails. Squawk!
You know this is a coffee bar, right? Not an actual bar?
We do. We're here for AA classes and thought we'd get a cup of coffee first.
Oh, make mine a decaf.
Do you need an extra shot of willpower on that? Squawk!
I've got to be absolutely sure about the definition of the word mocha. There can't be a single drop of alcohol in my flocktail.
Well, if you're here for a meeting, you've come to the right place.
Oh, I love your shoes. Where'd you get those?
Oh, these old things? I got them at Neiman's Last Call. Vanilla blonde makes it pay less prices.
And your shirt looks fabulous. Let me guess. Tajay.
How can you tell?
Got this tag hanging from your collar.
So what brought you two boys here?
We were sent here by Harris County Judge. Apparently, you'll be arrested for having a hummingbird feeder in your car.
I told you that was a hand-blown glass water bong when I bought it.
You can go to jail for possession of paraphernalia? Were you using it to do drugs?
Well, they also found 100 plastic Ziploc bags and a $20 package of stuff. It must have fallen on my feathers.
We got possession of a class one substance. The Ziploc bags, though, were actually for freezing homemade shrimp bouillon.
Oh. Yes. So, here we have meetings, not classes.
I don't care what you call it, I'm a little affordable. Last year I went to Flamingo State, and the classes are freaking expensive.
Girls are free.
Ooh, and they're run by hot daddies?
Well, I can't help you there.
Oh, these are newcomers, Armand and Albert.
Nice to meet you both.
Oh my God, are you guys flamingos?
I'm Armand, a Chilean flamingo. My mostly pale legs and hot pink joints.
And I'm Albert, a greater North American flamingo. You can tell by my more subtle plumage.
Far out.
And here, you're just plain old alcoholic flamingos. The garden variety kind.
My grandma had a bunch of those in her front yard.
I told my girlfriend she drew her eyebrows too high. She seemed surprised.
My wife screamed, "Judy, you haven't listened to one word I've said, have you? What a strange way to start a conversation with you."
Well, I asked my wife if I was the only one she ever slept with. "Yes," she said, "all the others were nines and tens."
My boyfriend asked me to put lube on the shopping list, and now I can't read any of it.
Oh no! I just accidentally swallowed a bunch of Scrabble tiles. My next poop could spell disaster.
I was so bored sitting at home last night that I programmed my universal remote. And I thought to myself, this changes everything.
I'm terrified of elevators.
That's understandable.
Yeah, I get it.
Oh, I'll just start taking steps to avoid them.
Hey, everyone.
Yes?
Why did the drag queen keep hitting herself in the head with a tambourine?
Why?
Because she just wanted to hear a good beat.
Oh!
What did I miss? I was running late.
The queen is never late. The rest of us are simply early.
Tell me a little bit more about Al-Anon. I'm trying to wrap my alcoholic head around it.
Sure. So let's frame it in the context of AA.
Okay.
If AA teaches you how to face your fears, then Al-Anon will teach you how to face your fears, and then your in-laws.
Sounds a little bit like advanced AA. Fighting addiction while navigating the minefield of a family dysfunction at the same time?
Yes! Al-Anon is like learning to ride the emotional roller coaster of watching the emotional roller coaster of another person.
I think I'm getting it. So, like, in AA, we have to admit that we have a problem with alcohol. In Al-Anon, you have to admit that someone else has a problem with alcohol. Yes. And that's driving you crazy.
Yes! You're finally catching on. You know, all we really need to know is how to sit our ass down in these meetings.
And that we're only as sick as our secrets.
No, not me. Not me. I can totally keep secrets.
Okay.
It's not people I tell them to that can't keep them.
Let's go.
One ringy dingy. Two ringy dingy. Three ringy dingy. Four ringy dingy. There you are, Phoenicia. I've been trying to get a hold of you. I haven't heard from you since before last week's Christmas party. You did what? And what? With who? If someone could hear the other side of this conversation, they'd be very shocked right now. Phoenicia, I'm worried about you. We need somewhere you can go. If only there was somewhere I knew that we could send you. Nope, nothing comes to mind. What'd you have for Christmas dinner? Oh, we had what we always have. Lamb, duh. Lamb, duh. Lamb, duh. Phoenicia, I know where we can send you.
Attention everybody, here's the next group. Goldie, Billy, Gabby, Adele, Cher, and Shakira. Please make your way to the stage.
Funny that they have us auditioning with everyone else. Maybe they're trying to raise awareness and promote the event.
Oh, they're gonna be lucky to have us all.
Okay, people, let's be quiet. We have a lot of contestants. So, first up is Billy.
That's you!
Hi, Billy. What will you be performing for us today?
I've prepared a dance number. You may recognize it.
Oh, fine. Proceed.
Do it.
he sees that my hips don't lie, he won't be able to handle the truth.
Thank you, Billy. That was incredible. Next up, Shakita.
It's Shakita.
Nice Austrian, Shakira. Okay, proceed.
So they tell me that you're looking for a girl like me. So they tell me that you're looking for a girl like me. I'm looking for a girl like me.
Thank you, Shakira. This seems a little too exotic for our audience.
Second, I am a she-wolf!
I will be performing a monologue from Jeffrey Bessemore New Weaver as Deborah Morehouse. So you come to me and you say, Deborah, what can I do to feel better about myself and the world? And you know what I say? Love! It's real! It works! Go for it! Now, I'm not here as a priest or a guru or some kind of religious leader. I'm just someone who likes to talk. And I have people coming to me and saying, Deborah, I'm in love with an alcoholic. What should I do? And I say, don't look to me for answers. Look to yourself. Find that source of unconditional love. Find that source of all-encompassing, ultimate love. Surrender to that infinite love that will let you say, hey, fuck you!
Did that monologue well. Mercy. Next up, let's see. Up to the front. Ardell, up to the front.
Are you serious? It's Adele. A-D-E-L-E. Oh my goodness.
Very well, Adele. Of time, thank you. Gabby, you can come forward.
Gabby!
I'm going to be singing a little song from, a popular song from my country. Con todito, tap, tap, tap. Con las arriba, con las abajo. Arriba, abajo. Con todito, con todito. Con todito, tap, tap, tap.
That was amazing, Gabby. Please take your seat so I can call up the next performer.
Oh, no! This charade, I'd share, bitch! You know, Americans are really mortified when I tell them this, but you're a twat.
Oh my! Those are what I call divas! Goldie, Billy, Gabby, it goes without saying, you all are going to be in our variety show! You may exit the stand. Joanne, could you call up the next six people?
Of course.
Listen up for the next group. Dwayne, Laurel, Brett, Celine, Madonna, and Bad Bunny.
When you pull the meat out.
Inappropriate. And boring. How's this one? What do you call two lesbians in a closet?
What?
A liquor cabinet.
Relationships are hard, Dick.
Tell me about it. I just got dumped by my hot banker boyfriend. He said he was losing interest. Oh.
Are you being serious right now? My partner left me for financial reasons. They love money, and I didn't have any.
I have all the money I'll ever need, if I die by midnight.
Okay, I expected, I expected some baggage with that relationship, but I certainly didn't expect the entire cargo from the Titanic to race to the surface.
No more baggage for me, just friendships.
Like you and I.
Yeah, screw everyone else. In fact, I'm changing my name on Facebook to Benefits.
Huh?
That way, yeah, that way, when someone friends me, it'll tell them we're friends with benefits.
That makes me feel so special.
And why is that, Dan? Do you want to be friends with benefits, like all the rest?
Hold that thought. In the meantime, we have a great performance for you tonight by a duet made in heaven.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Elton John and Kiki Dee.
Gracious good afternoon to you. Have I reached the party to whom I am speaking? May I ask who's on the line? You'd like to remain anonymous. Can I ask why? Anonymity is the spiritual foundation. Honey, I'm not writing all that down. You're answering the phones, but you don't want to give your name. Sounds suspicious. Oh, you want to know who I am? Well, actually, I'm a 27-year-old gay man referencing a Lily Tomlin character from a TV show that aired decades before I was born. But for the sake of the joke, I'm Ernestine Tomlin of the telephone company. The higher power of telephone companies. This is the Lambda Center, is that correct? Good, now we're getting somewhere. My friend Phoenicia went there the other day and said you have signs on the wall that say think, think, think. Pretty interesting coming from people who drink, drink, drink. You're a friend of Bill's? Who is this Bill? Mafia? Foreign intelligence? Is he hot? This whole operation sounds fishy if you ask me. Hello? Hello? Oh, I was going to ask them to give Bill my number.
Talk about spam. That woman who keeps calling is nuts. I think she has an agenda.
A gay agenda, perhaps?
What do you think, Goldie?
Oh, me? I don't have agenda. Because I'm genderqueer, baby.
Do you go by they, them?
Who? Me?
Yes, those are actually pronouns.
That's true, they are. But seriously, my pronouns are why, God, why?
Well, I identify as milk chocolate. I go by he, him, and her, she.
Lame!
2024 called, we're not doing pronoun jokes anymore.
I'm glad these AA classes are beginning. I had way too much coffee.
Ooh, take a load of this girl next to me.
What's she doing?
She's taking pictures and then doing Snapchat filters on her phone. Oh, this is like an easy class.
I don't know about that. What if the final exam's very hard?
Taking selfies in class? That sounds like an easy A to me.
You know, there's no label whores in here. I can clock.
The only whore in here is you. Now hush.
A moment of silence. Followed by your serenity prayer. God.
They're chanting something. I knew it. It's a cult. I knew it.
Listen, you're asking God for three wishes. This is just like I dream of genie.
Is there anyone attending their very first AA meeting? Anytime, anywhere. Raise your hands. Hey!
Flamingo and alcoholic? I'm on. Also flamingo and, yes, alcoholic.
Welcome.
Hello!
Welcome!
Welcome.
Well, we're so happy you have us at these classes.
I suppose it's gonna be a first set meeting since we have two newcomers.
What the flock is a first step meeting?
Probably where we get our hooded cloaks in a book on Satanism. I don't care. As long as it's about us.
Hi, my name's Richard, and I'm an alcoholic.
Hi, Richard.
So, what it was like, what happened, and what it's like now. Blah, 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 blah.
Over there.
Maybe he's taking notes for the exam.
No, I can see him hitting send.
Would you like to share?
Who, me? What do they want me to do?
Share?
Is this a pop quiz?
I don't know, just share.
But I haven't prepared anything to share.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, kid. You're on your own.
It's all right. You don't have to share.
Coming back. I hope this class is almost over. My feathers are getting all wrinkled and everything.
Settle down. We're missing what everybody is saying. I'm sure all this is going to be on the exam. Now they want to stand up again.
I'm tired too. My legs are getting cramped.
Comes to chanting.
Be quiet. This could be on the exam. Maybe it's in the printed material.
He's a bag. It works if you work it.
And you're worth it.
Thanks for coming. Keep coming back.
I think he means keep coming back to here.
Easy does it. Oh, can I just poop myself again? I hate when that happens.
No, I think he means just take it easy. You know, relax.
I'm always easy.
You are a whore.
You know, that really wasn't so bad for a first class. But the judge said we have to do 6 months of this.
Well, that's what we get for driving under the influence and only using one leg.
So bad this year. At this rate, all the drug addicts will be turning their meth back into Sudafed.
Well, I was gonna convert to nihilism, but I thought that'd be pointless.
Pointless. What happened when the priest met a cannibal?
What?
The cannibal got his first taste of religion.
The Lord said unto John, come forth and receive eternal life. But John came in fifth and only won a toaster.
What's the difference between God and pizza?
What?
God cannot be taught.
Since my last confession.
Damn.
I committed an original sin. I poked a monkey in the butt with a soup spoon.
Well, that is original.
Before you criticize someone, walk a mile in their shoes. That way, when you do criticize them, you're a mile away and you have their shoes.
Thank you.
one ringy, oh, gracious, good afternoon to you, Mr. Quickdraw McGraw. Have I reached the party with whom I am speaking? Ms. Worley? Okay, Ms. Worley, this is Ms. Tomlin from the telephone company, and I'm calling to inquire about the odd telephone habits of your business establishment, the Lambda Center. You use Verizon? Ugh. No, this is not AT&T, T-Mobile, or Cricket. This is the telephone company, the higher power of I'm trying to speak your language here, lady. Okay, now that that's out of the way, I'd like to ask you about your instrument. Ooh. Are you using it now? Is it in your hand? Good, that'd be strange if it wasn't. Now, what is it you use your instrument for over at the Lambda Center, Ms. Worley? Mostly to call a cab or an Uber? Uber, ma'am, please don't speak German at me. That makes me uncomfortable. Oh, but you take mostly incoming calls, not very many outgoing. Yes, I'm usually on the receiving end too, if you know what I mean. I'm a bottom. Well, that about clears things up for me, Ms. Worley. You and your fellow alcoholics can just go on having the time of your life at the Lambda Center. Make sure to pay your bills promptly. I know you people like to take things one day at a time, but we bill monthly.
I'm sitting at a table again, playing someone else.
Oh, I'm so excited to meet Casper Voorhees. I've read all of his books.
Oh my God, his book, I Picked My Face Off, really helped me get off TV. I haven't finished it yet, but I love it so far.
I was never addicted to math. Or even tried it, for that matter. I just love his self-help suggestions, like how to get off the hot rail and back on the railroad. You know, I don't think I'd try it, but you never know.
Try what? Meth?
Yeah! I mean, I know I won't. I just learned so much from his book, Sleeping with Your Dentist, How to Get Free Dental Care. It just gave such easy to understand, step-by-step instructions like how to pick the right dentist, what to wear in the dental chair, and how to perform oral hygiene.
I never knew he wrote self-help books while he was on meth.
Oh, yes. One of the better ones, The Downward Curve, Eat Less, Sleep Less. It really helped me balance my diet and my need for less sleep. Gosh, this line is just not moving.
I'm still having trouble understanding how he could have written best-selling books before he got clean.
Oh, he has a whole book devoted to house cleaning that I just love. It's called Wink Wink Little Pipe, How to Keep Your Home and Glassware Sparkling Clean.
These book titles sound fake. You really read all of these? Honestly, I just began reading his book, My Fabulous Life, How I Got Rich, following my meth habit. I had no idea he got rich writing books while he was high on crystal meth.
Oh, yes. You have got to read Doing Methematics. How to slow your curve and keep your job. It's excellent.
excellent.
Oh my God, I read that one. It was really helpful.
Wasn't it? Yes.
Did you ever use crystal meth?
Me?
Heavens no, but I did pick up his book called The Tic Tac Diet. I knew nothing about him, but in that book, the way he explains how to turn lemons into lemonade, literally, I make the best lemonade.
Yes, it's so good. What's the name of his latest book? I can't remember it right now off the top of my head.
Well, it's actually called Off the Top of My Head. The Meth Guide to Power Bottoming.
Oh, I love it! I know I would. I love all of his books. This line just still isn't moving, is it? What could possibly be the holdup?
Well, Casper's just so chatty and flirty up there, taking his time.
Yeah, maybe he taught himself how to talk endlessly from one of his own books.
Well, no doubt. He wrote it with your tongue. Help me talk incessantly. The way he outlines everything, it just makes perfect sense.
Yes.
Everybody can understand it.
Yes.
I don't need to read any of these books. I know how they all end. And it's not good. Fuck this shit.
Well, he just can't. He just doesn't understand Casper's self-help philosophy. A lot of people just can't.
Totally, you're right. But, you know, he is gonna miss out on the free giveaway.
Oh no.
I heard that Casper is giving a free power crystal with each autograph. They have healing powers, you know?
They do.
Listen up, everyone.
If any of y'all are using the Lambda phone, please keep your calls right to recovery. Mike E says we're being monitored by the federal government for suspicious activity.
Suspicious? Helping another alcoholic is considered suspect now?
Girl, relax. He just said be careful. Don't have a gal.
I'm paranoid enough as it is. Aww. I've already told my therapist that all my friends think so.
Oh, what did he say?
She.
Oh.
She said, relax, Richard. They're not your friends.
Well, that's a terrible thing to say to a patient.
Well, she didn't really say it. I just know she was thinking
it. Well, I have a crush on a girl who is paranoid. She thinks she has a stalker.
Oh, poor thing. Will you ask her out on a date?
I don't think so. I followed her all the way home last night, and I didn't see any stalker. I think she's delusional.
I once knew a dyslexic, paranoid, agnostic, insomniac. He'd lie awake at night and wonder if there really is a dog.
A perfectionist walked into a bar but immediately walked out. It's because the bar wasn't set high enough.
You know, I have an inferiority complex. Sadly, it's not good enough.
Well, I was hospitalized due to a peekaboo incident. Now they have me in the ICU.
Most people are shocked when I tell them I'm a really bad electrician.
I bought some shoes from a drug dealer recently. I don't know what he laced them with, but I've been tripping all day.
When they're traveling, like they plan on shitting themselves twice a day. No, just me.
I was going to say I feel for you until I realized the feeling I have is nausea.
You want to know what I really want to know, y'all?
What?
Why am I the only one of us that has two shit jokes?
Oh, shit.
That's shit. Ain't that some shit?
Yes, it is.
Thank you.
much as we did.
Hey, I thought you quit smoking.
I did. I just like pretending.
Okay. If we're gonna pretend, I would like to have one of those flocktails. Are those two cockatoos still around?
You know, who are we kidding? That's not us anymore.
I know.
You want to get out of here and maybe get into a little bit of trouble?
We just did a whole show for this AA club, and now you want to get into trouble?
Ugh, I'm just suggesting Barnaby's.
By the way, I noticed you changed your name on Facebook to Benefits.
I was hoping you'd see that.
To help raise money for our play, because, you know, money was tight, so we had to get some extra funds. So we want to thank all of y'all for supporting us and continue to support the Lambda Center. Keep coming to these events, because this is what we do, or I did as a fundraising chair, to help raise money for the center. So as you see events, please come, please support the center, because without y'all, the center would not be here. So I want to thank y'all once again. And Happy New Year, everybody! That's